We're happy to have with us this morning former Secretary of State and soon-to-be Congresswoman from the 6th District, Karen Handel. Karen, come on out here. I'm going to talk about you a second before I let you talk. Here we go. Under this lady's leadership as Secretary of State, we implemented a strong voter ID system, which has been in place and working well since 2007. When she was Secretary of State, she also reduced the budget of that office and streamlined its operations. Prior to that, she served as chairman of the Fulton County Commission, not an easy job, but she jumped in and managed to balance the Fulton County budget. In 3 weeks, we are going to send Karen Handel to Congress. Right now, please join me in welcoming her to our convention. Karen Handel.
Well, good morning, fellow Republicans. Good morning, my very, very great friends. To quote our mutual friend, Tom Price, it is a great day to be a Republican. Folks, we have the White House and President Donald Trump, Vice President Pence. We have our very own in the cabinet and HHS Secretary Tom Price and our Sonny Perdue as Ag Secretary. Yeah, they deserve an applause, y'all. And we know we have great leadership right here in the state of Georgia, starting with Governor Deal, all of our constitutional officers, our legislators, and our city and county elected officials. Yeah, it really is a great day, a great time to be a Republican. Today, as Georgia Republicans, we have a little business to take care of, electing our officers for the state party. And I just want to reiterate what I said last night. We have a lot of really talented, terrific individuals who are running for these leadership positions. They are your friends, and they are my friends. Still, there can only be one winner for each post, and our party will have new leadership when we leave today. But our mission remains constant, and that is to elect Republicans and advance conservative principles and ideas. Our opposition, they are determined, they are united, united in their anger, united in their intolerance of anyone who would dare to disagree with them, united in their ultra-liberal values. So the new Georgia GOP leadership, our leadership as we leave today, will only be as strong and as effective as we are united. Now, in case you haven't heard, we've got a little action going on in the 6th Congressional District. Nancy's coming down to Georgia. She's looking for a seat to steal. Now, folks, I really don't know if Nancy Pelosi can play the fiddle, but what I do know is she found herself a candidate born out of the left's resistance movement, a candidate that she thinks is her golden fiddle. Well, Nancy, my name's Karen, and it might be a sin, but I'll take your bet you're gonna regret, cause Georgia's got Handel in. Yeah, it kind of feels like all hell's broken loose in Georgia in the 6th District. Nancy Pelosi and her pals, they actually think they're coming into Georgia, into the 6th District, and they're gonna buy this guy a seat. He doesn't even live in the district, folks. Now my opponent, he keeps talking about how he's gonna be accountable to his donors who are powering his campaign. Well, those donors, 95% of them, they live outside of the 6th District, outside of Georgia. I don't think the 6th District is gonna let people from California, New York, and Massachusetts tell us who our next congressman is gonna be. I'm going to be accountable to the people in the 6th District because I live there. Steve and I have lived there for almost 25 years. And anybody in this room who knows me well knows that I am nobody's puppet. My opponent has been misleading and deceiving the people of the 6th District and the people of this state. Most of his commercials conveniently forget to mention that he's a Democrat. He rarely mentions that he's backed by Nancy Pelosi, Bernie Sanders, Elizabeth Warren, Jane Fonda. Heck, he even had Kathy Griffin tweeting for him. He talks about cutting spending, but folks, he counts as his mentor, Hank, Juan might tip over, Johnson. He says he's going to be a strong ally for Israel and stand up for our military, but his boss, Hank, Juan might tip over, Johnson, is one of the most anti-Israel members of Congress, using vile terms to describe the Jewish people. My opponent has inflated his resume while having the audacity to deceive the voters of this state and the people of the 6th about my record of service as Fulton County Commission Chairman, as Secretary of State. This guy has even gone so far as to say that he's been on the front line of fighting terrorism and defending our freedoms. His idea of the front line, sending a team, a film crew, to make a film. All of our veterans in the room, please stand. Ladies and gentlemen, these brave men and women, they know what the real front line is. They're protecting our freedom and protecting this great nation, and we thank you. They made great personal sacrifice. And they did it with determination, courage, resolve, and sometimes not even with the full backing of this country. They sure as heck didn't do it with a video camera. The people of the state and in the 6th District, you know me. People have said that I'm resilient, that I'm tough. Some of you have even called me stubborn and maybe some other names that I haven't heard, but that's all right. I embrace all of that for this reason. I am a fighter because I'm going to fight for the people of the 6th District and be the fiercest advocate I can possibly be for them. I have never been afraid to stand up and challenge the status quo. I have never been afraid to stand up and do what is right and do what is best for you. And that's the kind of tenacity that I'm going to take to Washington as your next congressman. Now, beyond my experience, you know, I find it interesting when my opponent talks about how he's going to cut spending. Well, folks, I've done it. As Secretary of State, I didn't take the easy route with furloughs. I actually went in and realigned that budget and cut it by nearly 20% while also improving the customer service and making efficiencies in that agency. He talks about rooting out corruption. Well, I've done it. Just ask then-Sheriff Jackie Barrett, who sold nearly $7 million. I saw her out of office when no one thought I would. Talk about policies as Secretary of State. I was told I couldn't get photo ID done, but I went to work with a great team, with Randy Evans, and with the great Ann Lewis, and we got photo ID through the courts after multiple losses, and today, photo ID stands as a model law of integrity for elections in this country. But beyond my career experience, my work experience, I have life experience, ladies and gentlemen, the kind that you get by overcoming adversity. Overcoming adversity in life is how an individual develops determination, resilience, the ability to stand for what they believe in, just to know who you are. I have the career experience, the skills experience, and the life experience to be a good leader, a good, solid leader for the people of the six. Because these are challenging times for our country. We are facing real and very serious issues. Terrorism, protecting our borders, curtailing the ever-expanding creep of a federal government that wants to spend more and be more engaged in our lives every single day. These are serious issues that require a serious leader who has the background and the life experience to actually get the job done. Now, I said on election night that we needed to have all hands on deck. And I want to thank you again, as I did last night, because that call was answered and then some. People from across this state, across this country, from our national elected leadership in President Trump, Vice President Pence will be here on Friday, Speaker Ryan has come, every member of our Republican congressional delegation, our governor, our lieutenant governor, our Speaker of the House, every legislator, every constitutional officer, and every one of you in this room have come together to help me. And I will be forever grateful for that. From St. Simons in Savannah, to Macon, to Fayetteville. Where are you, Fayetteville? From Rome to LJ to Dalton, you have had my back. And to my special and great friends in the 6th District, you are the front line in this effort, in this battle to hold this seat. You can count on me to do my job, and I know I will be able to count on you. This seat has the great legacy of Tom Price, Johnny Isaacson, and Newt Gingrich. We will indeed give Nancy Pelosi her due, because the 6th, it is not going blue. With your help, in unity, with great determination, we will send a message on June 20th and kick some ass off. God bless y'all. God bless Georgia. God bless the great United States of America. Thank you.